Hello guys, so in today's video I want us to have a look at how we can identify rogue DHCP server in our network. Then I also want us to look at how we can set up email notification, and we are going to use Gmail for that, so that you can always receive an email notification whenever there's a rogue DHCP server in your network. Then after that, I would also want us to look at how we can prevent the same rogue DHCP server from interfering with your network, and also from interfering with the clients that you have on your network. So how does a rogue DHCP server occur? This is when probably a client by mistake has unplugged the one cable and plugged it on a different port, which is not the one cable. Which is not the one port, that is. So in that case, you'll find that the client's router will be sending back DHCP to your main router and to other clients as well. So we want to be able to notice that, and we also want to be able to prevent that from messing up the entire network and also from messing up with other people's work. So let's start, because I want us to use GNS to achieve this. So I already, as you can see, I already have my MikroTik router over here, and so let's log into it. Here it is. So the first thing that I want us to do, this is our core router, so it's the one that is allowed to give out DHCP addresses. It's the only one that's allowed to have DHCP addresses to your clients. So let's set it up. So let's start with first of all creating a bridge. So add. Okay. So let's add some few ports inside that bridge. Let's start maybe with port 3. Okay. Let's go to with a 4. Okay. Okay, that is already added. 4. There. Okay, let's add a third one. Maybe 5. Okay. Let's leave it as that. At that. So let's give that bridge an IP address. This should not be here. So add. So let's give it, say, 10.10.10.1/24. And this is going to be on the bridge. So apply. Okay. So let's set up a DHCP server. DHCP server. So DHCP, this goes to the bridge. Next, 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 next. Maybe let's have these as a Google DNS. Okay, next, that's successful. So that is done. Let me just confirm if I have internet connectivity here. Yeah, I'm good. So the router can be able to send an email. So how do you want now to set up an alert for this? So you want to go to IP. DHCP server and alerts. Then you want to come to add, and the interface where your DHCP is on the bridge, and the valid server, this is supposed to be the MAC address of that bridge. So let's get it. We go to bridge, then this is the MAC address. We copy that. Then we come and input it there. Then there's a script that you'll need to put here so that it can be able to send an email to you whenever there's a rogue DHCP server that has been identified. So here is the script. I'm going to leave this script down in the description so that you can be able to use it. So let's copy this. Copy. Then we paste it there. Apply. Okay. So the next thing that I want us to do is set up email for this. So you need to come to Tools. Email, then the server here, this is the Gmail server, and the IP for that is 74.125.142.108. And the port number here is going to be 587. So, and you should set this to yes. Then from, this is going to be your email address. The user is also going to be the email address. And the password, this is going to be the password that you use to log into your email address. So I have already set up an email here. Let's just wait for it to open up. Yeah, this is my email. As you can see, Mr. Wisp. So I'm going to use that. Let's write it here. It's Mr. Wisp 254@gmail.com. Copy. Paste that, my password as well, and that looks okay. So you can apply. So another important thing that you really need to do on your email side is let me show you. You need to come to email, then come to your account here. Then you need to come to security, then scroll all the way down. Then you need to turn on access for less secure apps. So we need to turn this on so that you can be able to receive the email. So that is updated. So we can come back to our Gmail. Then our microtik, so we can try and test if this will work. So two, it could, it's the same Gmail address, and from is the same Gmail address. Our subject could be test mail, and the body could also be test mail as well. And let's send email. Let's come to our logs and see what happens if the email has been sent. Here you can see from the logs it says that email has been sent. So let's go to our email. Yeah, here is the email, test mail. So once that is done, let's now try and input a rogue DHCP, introduce a rogue DHCP in our network and see what happens. If we are going to receive a notification for that. So we are going to go back to GNS. Let's add a second microtik router, which is going to act as now the rogue DHCP. So let's start it. Then let's log into it using the console. System is booting up. Let's wait for it to boot up just a minute. There you are. The default credentials of a new MikroTik is admin. The password remains empty. You're going to say no. It's requiring us to input a new password. Enter. Let me change the name for this. System identity set name. Let's call this site 1. Let's enable Roman. Tool Roman set enable. Yes, enter. This is so that we can be able to access it through Winbox. You can check out my previous video about GNS. You're going to find out why. So after that is done, let's now create a link between the two. And it's going to go to that port. So let's log in through MikroTik. Let's log in through Winbox. New Winbox. And let's connect to Roman so that we can be able to see the new MikroTik that we just brought up. Here it is. Connect. So what we want to do is we want to set DHCP on this router so that it powers back DHCP to our main router, something which should not be happening, and see if we get an email notification for that. So what we now need to do is we need to come to IP, DHCP server. Let's create an IP first. Maybe we are going to do it on which port did we connect to? This is Ether 1, okay. So we come to this IP address. Let's add a new IP, let's say 172.20.30.1/24. This is going to Ether 1. Apply. Okay, so let's set up a DHCP. So this one also goes to Ether 1. Next, this is supposed to be 172.20.30.0/24. Next, looks good. Next, successful. So let's open our main MikroTik router, open the logs, and you can see that a rogue DHCP has been identified. Here is the log, and you can also see that an email has been sent to our email account. So you can now see, you can see that the alert has been sent, and you can now be able, you should now be able to take the next course of action. There it is. So that is how you identify a rogue DHCP, and that is how you also set up, that is also how you set up email notifications so that you can be notified in case such a thing happens. So, how do we also prevent this from affecting our network? So, one thing that we need to do is client isolation. So, what you need to do is you come to interface, I'm sorry, you come to the bridge and the ports. So you need to come to open the ports, and the horizon value here should be 1. Okay, the next port horizon value should be 1. Okay, the next port horizon value should be 1. That is how you set up client isolation for MikroTik. So what this means is that any port with a horizon value of 1 is not supposed, and it cannot be able to communicate to another port with the same horizon value of 1. So this means that all clients who are connected to that particular port, this client is only going to communicate to that port, and this client will not pollute clients who are on the next port. I hope I'm clear on that, and you can get what I'm trying to say here. And the next thing is that let's say you have a ubiquity access point, and maybe it has a numerous number of clients connected to it. Ubiquity also offers when you go to wireless, there's a place where you are also able to just click on client isolation, and all these clients will now not be able to see each other. And that is so important, because when now a client pollutes the DHCP, this client will not be able to affect any other client in the network. So guys, thank you for that. And if you have any questions regarding this, please leave a comment down below so that I can know what you want me to talk about next time, what you want us to have a look. If you have any questions, please let me know. And guys, please, let's grow this channel. Kindly subscribe, leave a like, and also share the video with your friends so that the channel can be able to grow as we proceed together. So thanks for that, and have a lovely day. Goodbye.